Hey, Jay Muse here, and I want to talk about something that's in my ear. Because you're probably like, well, why is that in his ear, and why isn't it being smoked? Well, the problem is I cannot smoke it, but I like to be close to it. I like to smell it, I like to feel it, and love it. But I'm sober, I can't smoke, it'd be breaking my sobriety. I'm all about it, I love it, live it, but I just can't smoke it right now. But I like to hold it, so I'm gonna keep it close here like this. Picture this, many, many, many moons ago, I'm a young buck. Small town of Highlands, New Jersey. Me and my buddies used to hang out with this kid, and his dad grew marijuana in his yard. And it was crazy because, again, at that age, it's like we knew people who smoked and all that, and we had smoked some here and there, but it wasn't really accessible enough to be doing it all the time. But I remember my buddy was, you know, excited and bragged to us and showed us this alleyway on the side of his house, sort of hidden, of his dad's plants that were like humongous. And he had all these strings tied through there and all this with bells on them, like booby traps. One day me and one or two of my buddies had the great idea of let's go get those plants. No one's home. We knew no one was home because we spoke to our other buddy, which wasn't very nice, but we spoke to our other buddy, and him and his dad were going out for the day. So we went to his house. We're throwing these plants over the fence and stuff. We have garbage bags. We stuff them in the garbage bags. And when we were done, we could not fit in a bag, or even we were getting nervous and running out of time. The biggest plants with the most buds and all the craziness, we couldn't get that one and bring it with us. So we decided to run home. We go home. Thinking about it now, it was horrible because we brought it home, pulled everything off. We were trying to dry it in the microwave, and then we roll it and smoke it, which, if you know, you people out there know, that doesn't really work so well that way, to dry out bud with the microwave. That's weird, funny part one. Part two is, as we're doing this, me and my buddy, we get a phone call, and my buddy goes, oh my God, dude, oh my God, I just got home, man, my dad dropped me off, and I went and looked on the side of the house, all his plants were stolen, and I'm crazy, I don't know what I'm gonna do, he's gonna blame me, and I was like, no way, dude, that sucks, that really sucks, man, what are you gonna do? He's like, I don't know, and I was like, well, wait a sec, if he's gonna blame you already for stealing all the other plants, why don't you just steal the other one as well and bring it here and we could smoke it? And he's like, oh my God, you're right. So we got our buddy to steal the last plant, bring it to my house. And so we didn't tell him about the other plants, but then he shared his big plant with all of us. And I was like, oh my gosh, on stage, I was like, I gotta tell you, my buddy's here. I'm so excited to see him. I gotta tell you a story. And I told a story about this situation. I was like, look, before I start this, I don't even know if you ever figured this out or knew this, but this is what happened. And after the show, him and I hung out for like an hour, you know, catching up and all that. And he's like, bro, I never knew that. So it was pretty crazy because 18 years later, he found out that we were the ones who took the original plants and then called him. He called us and then we got him to take the other one. So anyway, there's a little story, a little tidbit from Jay Muse about cannabis. Snooch.